normally we record in layers and then we change them and I chop them up. And it, usually the process of making the record happens whilst we're in the studio. We go in with a kind of an idea of what we want to do and then we work it out as we record. I mean, there are thousands of times in the studio when I thought this is so good. I mean, really, every time that you finish a song is a really great feeling. You know, every time you finish a mix of a song, it's like you've made something from nothing. It's like the reason why I still do it, that feeling. I grew up with it. We always had pets in our house. I haven't got any now, though. We always used to have like cats and dogs. And I was probably 7 years old when I first became aware of who Jimi Hendrix was. And that's like 1967, 1968. He just represented... I suddenly realised that there was a big, colourful world out there. Because at that age, everything's to do with kind of just school and home. You don't really do very much at the age of like 7, 8, 9. You have no independence, you haven't really have no power. And you don't for a long time, but... I began to dawn on me that this weird bloke played guitar and sang as a job. And I thought it just stuck with me. So all the way through school, I would just think, people say, what do you want to be? And I'd think, I'd say something, and then I'd be a gardener, or in my head, I'd think, probably Jimi Hendrix. I think the stupidest thing that they're doing, actually, is the amount that they're forcing, just as an example, like the amount that they're forcing people to pay for downloads is too much. Like that they all just got together and forced Apple to increase the price of downloads on iTunes. And in fact, they should be reducing it. They should become like 5 cents a song, and all the money goes to the artist. I mean, they haven't really quite grasped things, but there's been this ongoing struggle for the last 5 years, and the majors have been struggling to kind of contain and constrain how music's like distributed on the internet. And they've come up with such half-baked ideas, and none of them have really worked. And I mean, if you buy it now, at the moment, the way that current rates are, if you buy this our album on iTunes, track by track, you'll actually end up paying almost as much as if you went and bought the CD. That's just one very obvious big mistake that they're making, because, and as an artist, it hurts, because they're forcing people to download music illegally still, because no one's going to pay, like, you know, 50 cents for a song. I mean, why should you? It exists as digital information, but it doesn't cost anyone anything, you know, it's like... So anyway, that's one thing. The other mistake is that, which hurts a lot of younger artists, it doesn't really impact on us as much, is the ludicrous amount of money that they spend on things like Pop Idol and all that sort of shit. These ridiculous competitions to find one band that will sell like a million albums for like 1 month, and then no one hears about it, you know. And it's that, it's this kind of constant... Everything's speeded up to the point where everything has to happen now, everything has to sell now. And there's almost like a disregard for like cultivating artists who will like, you know, make music in the future. So, I suppose for me it's the inability to kind of comprehend a life without the person that I love. I couldn't imagine it. I think that it's that sense that you would honestly feel like you would die if that person wasn't there. And there's lots of artists down the years that I can connect with. I mean, mainly it's like you're vocalist, so you can feel the singing from the heart, and you just like, you want to just lose yourself in that music. But it's also, strange enough, my favourite music that for the last few years to listen to when I'm feeling a bit down is Mogwai, and they don't really have any vocals. And I think the reason is because it's the most beautiful music I've ever heard, and there's no words, so I actually sing. So I just sing to myself when I'm listening to it. So it's, I find it very therapeutic, actually. They're the best band on the planet. It's not exclusively Tony Blair. It's really aimed at Western media and their portrayal of everything as being black and white, and it's the simplification, the dumbing down of culture. It's taken like, I just feel in the last few years that it's almost like the tapes running backwards. We're all being kind of like taken back to the womb, and everything you talk to out of the television set, as you know, I feel like I'm 5 years old. These are the bad guys. It's a shame, because I felt that 4 years ago we might have a leader that would actually do socially do some good in our country, because I thought he had some good ideas, but it's like you're constantly let down by people, you know. It's unfortunate, seems to be, it's human nature. Well, because when I do this, it's the gaps between us doing this are quite long, and I forget sometimes how disturbed it makes me feel, you know, the constant attention doing things like this, doing press conferences. I don't really feel comfortable doing it. I like singing. But the rest of it I can kind of do without most of the time. I've had a cello in my house for more than 10 years with a Learn How book on it, and I still haven't got past page 3. If I could decide I'd want to be something else, and if I had the ability to be something else and enjoy it, I would still pick up a guitar and play. So I'd still end up being a musician, because that's what the thing I enjoy most is making music. So it's weird, really. I mean, I'd like to be an astronomer. I've had a telescope for about 15 years now. It's not my one hobby, as astronomy. But I, there's nothing that's major that I would do differently. I've always followed my instincts. Every decision that I've made with regards to like the band and what I do with the band has been how I feel, it's like what I feel should be right. But I've never really taken anyone's advice about anything. So the mistakes that I've made have been my mistakes. I could probably make them again, even if I went back and I said, look, don't do this. I'd say, what do you know?